Hello. In the last lesson, we discussed Gauss's law. What does Gauss's law deal with? Do you remember the concept of Gauss's law? Gauss's law gives you a statement about the net flux either leaving or entering a surface. What does it relate to? The net flux leaving a surface is proportional to the amount of charge inside the surface. To be more specific, the net charge leaving a surface is 4 pi k times q inside. Or it will be the amount of charge inside divided by epsilon naught. Now, this principle can be very conveniently used to obtain electric field due to extended charged objects. Now, you can actually avoid using calculus in many occasions. Well, we're going to look at a couple of cases where we can find the electric field due to extended charged objects using Gauss's law. All right, let's do the first case. To begin with, we will discuss electric field at a point due to an infinite plane charge. Now, what is an infinite plane charge? Now, consider a plane charge that carries charge and it is infinite. It is extended in all directions to infinity. In other words, it simply means a very large plane charge. Now, what is the electric field at a point due to an infinite plane charge? Well, what do we do? There is a standard method that we use in using Gauss's law. We can use Gauss's law to find an electric field near an infinite plane charge. All right, consider an infinite plane charge. I have drawn a section of that infinite plane charge, and the plane charge carries a surface charge density sigma. Field lines leaving the upper as well as lower surface of the plane surface will be perpendicular to the surface. There will be electric field lines leaving the top surface and also leaving the bottom surface. Is that right? Assume that the charge carried by the plane surface is positive. That means electric field lines will be originating from it. So above the surface, the field lines will be directed upward, and below the field lines will be directed downwards. Just like we have shown here. The field E has the same magnitude, so above the surface and below the surface, the magnitude of the field at any point near it will be the same, but they are oppositely directed. Is that right? Now, in order to find the field at a point, we choose a Gaussian surface which encloses a small portion of the charge carried by the plane. Now, this is the standard method of using Gauss's law. For example, let us say we want to find the electric field due to the charge carried by a plane surface like this. Now, what is the meaning of a Gaussian surface? All right, this is my plane charge and I want to find the electric field at this point. Can you see where I'm pointing? Now, we want to construct a Gaussian surface which contains that point. Now, the Gaussian surface in this case can be something like this. We call it a pillbox. You know what a pillbox is? Something cylindrical. So, this is the Gaussian surface. Now, that means when you put the Gaussian surface on the plane charge, inside the Gaussian surface, there is a certain amount of charge. Now, How much charge is there? What is the area of this gaseous, this Gaussian surface? If the area is A of the Gaussian surface, then the amount of charge inside the Gaussian surface will be that A multiplied by sigma, where sigma is the charge density on the plane. Now you can see the electric field above the plane will be directed upward, and below it will be directed downward. And the point where I want to find the electric field is on this pill box, which we call the Gaussian surface. So in order to use Gauss's law to find the electric field at a point, we take a Gaussian surface that contains the point where we want to find the electric field. And the Gaussian surface will be enclosing a part of the surface so that we know the electric charge inside the Gaussian surface. Why do you want to know the electric charge inside the Gaussian surface? Because we are going to use Gauss's law. What does Gauss's law say? It says the net flux that leaves a surface is 4 pi k times q inside. We need to know the amount of charge inside the Gaussian surface. In my diagram, this is the Gaussian surface, which is like a pillbox. So, in order to find the field at a point, we want to find the field at a point somewhere here. So we take a Gaussian surface that contains the point where you want to find the electric field. And that Gaussian surface encloses a small portion of the charge carried by the plane. Okay. The Gaussian surface we have chosen is in the form of a box or a cylinder. You can actually take any convenient shape that you choose. Since the curved surface of the cylinder is parallel to the planes, you see, this is the curved surface of the cylinder, like the pillbox I used was this, like cylindrical. The curved surface are parallel to the electric field lines. That means there is no flux leaving or entering the curved surface. There is flux leaving the upper surface and there is flux leaving the lower surface. But there is no electric flux leaving the curved surface. Why? Because the curved surface is parallel to the electric field. If A is the area of the top surface of the Gaussian surface, and E is the electric field that we want to find. Suppose E is the electric field at this point, and A is the area of the top surface, then what is the net flux leaving the top surface? The flux leaving the top surface will be E times A. I suppose this is now very familiar to you, because E, the electric field, is flux per unit area. So the total flux leaving that surface, which is actually a circle, is that right? This is a circle. That A is that area. And I want to find the electric field at a point on my pillbox over here. So the net flux leaving that surface will be E times A. Similarly, there is a similar quantity of flux leaving the lower surface. All right. Now, since the flux leaves at both faces of the cylinder, the amount of flux leaving the upper surface will be E times A. And the amount of flux leaving the lower surface is also E times A. So what is the total flux leaving the cylindrical surface? That will be 2 times E times A. And according to Gauss's law, that net flux leaving the Gaussian surface must be equal to 4 pi k times q inside. Since A is the area of the plane which we talked about, the charge inside that Gaussian surface, what is the charge inside the Gaussian surface? Which is A times sigma. Therefore, the charge inside equal to A times sigma. We are now ready to use Gauss's law. What is Gauss's law? Gauss's law is phi net equal to Q inside divided by epsilon naught, which is the same as 4 pi k times Q inside. This is more convenient, so we will use this. The net flux equal to Q inside divided by epsilon naught, and Q inside is 2EA, and phi net equal to 2EA, and Q inside is A sigma. Let's replace those. We get 2EA equal to A sigma divided by epsilon naught, and notice A and A will cancel from both sides. And what is therefore E equal to? You can solve for E. E equal to sigma over 2 epsilon naught. Well, if you remember, in the last class, we used calculus to derive the same equation. The electric field very close to, this is the equation we obtained using the closed point approximation for the field near a plane charge. So, or the field near, if you remember, the field at the axis of a plane charge, when you use the closed point approximation, we obtain the same equation. And that we got it without calculus and without a lot of hassle. So what is the field at a point near an infinitely charged conductor? E equal to sigma over 2 epsilon naught. The field near an infinite plane charge is E equal to sigma over 2 epsilon naught. If I have an infinitely charged plane surface anywhere near, well, when we say near, a reasonable distance, is that right? Anywhere near this plane charge, the field will be sigma over 2 epsilon naught. Now that idea we will use as we go on, so that must be very clear to you. And sigma over 2 epsilon naught is the same as 2 pi k sigma. All right, let's do a problem. An infinite plane of surface charge density sigma equal to 4.5 newton nano coulomb per meter squared lies in the yz plane.